Jared Noski. Be ready. All set. Light flashing away. Racing, Roger the Roman missed the kick. He dropped Floyd straight back and Belt of the Grey, the first to leave. And he'll quickly zip over and head off Recoiled and Gigante. In behind them then, now starting to pick up ground, Roger the Roman. The Celt goes back in the field, so does War God. And Floyd in a tactical change today is back last of all, settling about seven from the leader. The lightly weighted Grey Galloper leads Belter as they come along the back of the course. It's Belter by a length and a half. Sitting off him is Recoiled. It's stablemate Gigante, third. Followed then by Roger the Roman, a little over a length to the Celt at the 600 post, and then came War God and Floyd back there last of all, about five or six from the leader. Up to the corner they come. Belter shows the way for Taylor Stone. They've got 400 left to travel. She kicked him away, coming around the turn, tried to get a break on Recoiled. Roger the Roman down on the inside of Gigante. The Celt, Floyd to the outside, popped the big question at the 200. Belter's the leader by 2.5 lengths. Second Recoiled, down the outside comes the Celt. It's Belter with 100 left to go, still clear from the Celt. Recoiled, then Floyd, but it'll be all the way for Belter. Belter was much too good. Conditions certainly playing in his favour. Great riders well in front. Belter beat home the Celt, Recoiled, and then came Floyd deeper out. Well, he went back, and probably not a great day for that. They were followed then by War God, then Gigante, who hasn't fired at all, and neither Roger the Roman for that matter. He dropped out to finish back there near the tail. Well, it's Belter there, 52.5 kilos. Led unpressured. He's run 1:10.26. They didn't seem to be going that quickly. 1:10.26, but he made the corner clearly in front of Recoiled. He had him off the bridle in a blink. They've run home in 34 and change. And Belter went to the post in cruise mode to score from the Celt, Recoiled. And it's a photo for fourth placing. Now, that is between War God and Floyd, who they went back with this afternoon, and it really hasn't been a great day for horses back in the field. Belter the winner by Denman from Twain for Wally Daly, trained by Sean Casey and ridden by Taylor Stone. Too good here in taking out the Amelia Park Lodge handicap. She got a great ride in front there. Taylor Stone, no pressure. She's with Brittany Taylor over there. They're about to keep each other company on the way back here to the scales. And that was a pretty easy victory for Belter there in race number four.
Hear me, Darren. We've had a few technical difficulties with this microphone, but hopefully you can hear me now because I do have Taylor Stone. And Taylor, what a victory there, right out in front with Belter. A fantastic win there.
Yeah, you know, he's gone really good. He was a really good run last start. I was really happy with him. He just got beat on the line, and it was good to see him up to his old tricks again today, out in front, nice and easy and relaxed. And we just had it our own way, and he was just good enough to win.
Were you concerned at all given the gut buster that he had? He was so tough in that last run right to the line. Were you concerned that he could be flat going into today, or in his prelim did he show that he was fresh and ready to go?
I definitely was a little bit worried, you know. Had such a hard run last start, fought back really hard, and, you know, Sean said he pulled up really well, and fortnight between runs helps, and he raced exactly the same today. There was no issues, so hopefully it's a nice long prep that he can have and keep winning and, you know, go out, have a little short spell and come back and be even better.
Now, that was a ride out in front, but it's important to note that on Wednesday you had two winners come from back in the field. So tell those people, you're no one-trick pony, are you?
No, you know, when you get the nice ones behind and nice ones out in front, it's a lot easier to ride. But, yeah, it's just good to show people that I can ride, you know, every way there is, and hopefully that helps get me a little bit more rides and a little bit more support from everyone else.
Well, congratulations, Taylor. You're doing absolutely amazing out there.
Thanks, Brittany.
Yeah, Taylor Stone kicking plenty of goals at the moment. That was a gem of a ride on Belter. No weight on his back again today. She went straight to the front, and Sean, that must have been pretty easy watching because your horse never really looked in danger.
No, it went really good. I thought that he might be pressured a little bit today, but the horse is just improving, and yeah, he's surprising me and probably everyone else. He's really coming up nice. He's having benefit of his last couple of starts with a light weight, but he's really promising horse. He's really, really personal besting every time he goes out.
Yeah, and that's a great sign. It's 17 starts now for 4 wins, but it's a big advantage when he can do what he does, jump and run, and makes it very hard for his opposition to catch him, especially around a track like Ascot.
Yeah, especially today with the rail being so true. There was every opportunity for all the horses, but a horse like him suited with the rail out. But I can't say any more than what he's putting on paper.
What's been the key to him this preparation?
Well, to be quite honest, this week I've been in Sydney all week, so Christy and Jake and Bonnie and all the staff have been looking after the horse, so I can't really say what we did this week.
But he's flying at the moment, and keep up that good work. Do you just continue on with him now, this preparation?
Yeah, while he's going good, he's nice and fit now. We don't have to do a lot of work with him. And, we just keep finding the right race and continue.
He's loving his racing. The punters loved him today as well. Job well done, Sean.
Thank you.
There's Sean Casey there, the winning trainer, with Belter taking out race number 4 on the card. We'll be back before race number 5, and can't wait to see the big fella Missile launch back at the races here.